Okay, let's do things this way. I was trying to use OBS to just capture my mundane working that I'm going to be doing today. Just screwing around in Unreal Engine, really. How should I explain what I'm doing? Today I'm messing around with some models that Casual Effects has uploaded to his website. Here, you got Morgan McGuire. He's got a whole bunch of neat things up here on his website. And I'm messing around with the Amazon Lumberyard Bistro. And you can't really see anything right now because it's dark. And it's your fault. So we're going to figure out everything with this, I think. And I don't need a filter there. We got lights here on the outside. And the lights are not coming through, so we gotta fix that real quick. Where's this? Let's get some lights up in here. I like that. I don't think the sky updated. Boom. 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 Okay. So we got that going through here. That looks good. We got RTX on. Brute force disabled. Let's just disable it for now. What else got here? Okay, we got ray trace reflections on. That's fine. We'll leave that on for now. We also have the skylight, which I will turn off. And we got sky atmosphere. That's fine. Exponential height fog. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Actually, no. We don't really need it. That doesn't... Okay, that's good. Everything's fine. Okay, that's how I want it to look for now. And I am going to figure out these materials. Start with the easiest thing. We got the doormat. Doormat said, feed your head. So, put there. And we have... is it under building textures? We're going to find out. No. Main door. What's the texture called here? Harris doormat 01. Okay. Oh, it's probably under prop. Bistro? No. Okay. Harris doormats. There's just a diffuse. So what are you doing here? Whoa, everything got confused. Thanks. Let's open up the search so I could close the search. What is this doing? Search results in prop textures. A confused explorer. Okay, well, if that's all this doormat has, then how am I going to go about making this friggin' thing? Okay. Let's make this a PBR texture real quick. That's fine. Dying. Okay. Got one light going on around here. I just want to shine it so I can see it better. I mean, are doormats shiny? What do you think? So we have the roughness, which... Oh, okay. Yeah. Black is more rough, and yeah. Looks like a doormat to me. Maybe like zero. Zero do. Let's see what that does. Save to file. Here's doormats. Let's make it a PNG. Save. So we got this here. We'll bring in the other ones. Just want this for now. Bring that over. Roughness. Save. Already looking better. Okay. Now, that normal map. That's just the normal map? Okay. Can't tell what direction is going what with this. So let's invert depth. That looks more right. Okay, and to verify this, I like to turn it into a parallax, not a displace, but parallax. And then I select the displacement map here. And that should be doing what I want it to do, but it's not. Give more samples. What are you doing? You're on there. Ah, there you go. Maybe it would help if I also put the normal map a little bit. Yeah, because they kind of work together, you know? Make it 10. Let's look at this a little closer. That doesn't look that bumpy. Like, it should be that bumpy. So, Can't I? Oh, yeah, I could. I can. Oh, too much. That's too smooth. It's not getting the kind of detail I want. It really isn't. It's auto edge. Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. I like that does. That's fine. I guess I'm going to have to live with it like this. I don't know. I just don't like that look. It's way too bumpy. Yeah, we could do that. Yeah, 95. Okay, I could deal with that. Yeah. So if that's how that looks, then the normal map will be good. Save the normal map. Import the normal map. It was imported as a normal map. Good. And normal. Okay, needs a little change. Let's bring this back to PBR. I like 10. Oh, that looks good. We do that and we reload. Oh. Re-import. There we go. Oh, there we go. There. Now we're cooking. Save that just in case. And what else do we need on this? We have base. You know, there's no metal. So, I mean, just... I just like to do that. I don't know why. Spec. We got some spec up in here. Please. Oh, yeah, I could just do PBR spec. Specular, which was this one. We're using roughness. I want roughness in specular, please. Nah, that's fine for a preview. Whatever. Is there really not? So you either use roughness with metalness, which there's no metal on this. So, I mean, let's get that specular in there, whatever. Bistro, prop, bistro, doormats. Call it spec. Sorry, I'm weird about lining things up because I have autism. There we go. And see how that looks. Looks like a doormat to me. And there's a couple different ways you could do specular. Like if that doesn't look quite the way you want, you could just take the green channel and see what that does. Okay, that lets it have a little bit of shine. A little bit. And that's good because this is probably made of rubber. It looks like rubber to me. Let's quickly put a point light over here. Yeah, it seems to be doing exactly what I would expect it to do if I was shining a light on it. I could go further and I could do parallax, but I might do that in this video. That's a very, very involved process, bringing parallax into this, but it might be neat to have on video. Okay, so we did a doormat, and I don't know how long I've been recording. Let's just get this floor. Tile hexagonal. Where do you think that is? Probably interior, building textures. There is that. Bring that in. It's already made for us. Thank you. So we got normals. And wait. Oh no, that was right. That's a weird pattern then. Okay. Let's save that just in case. I could start with the normal map, which is always weird to do. And what does that give me if I start with that? It gives me the normal, gives me displacement, metalness. It does give me a roughness, which is neat. Okay, and that is roughness from diff. That is a color map. Nope. Moving it. I didn't mean to move it. God damn it. Okay. How many different ways can you do a roughness in this? Yeah, roughness diff. Just from a diffuse. Okay. That's fine. Might as well add a specular. Okay. I keep moving it. God dang it. Okay. Hit that up in here. Let's go with it. Interior. No, it was building textures. I'm going to sort by date. Okay. Like before. We'll leave things up to chance, make sure it actually is zero metal, and then we have the specular. Then we have the roughness. Save that. Ah, looking good. Although, okay, there. I don't know why that was streaming in. That took a second for the normal to do that. You are a normal map, right? Yeah, good. Good, good. Save all. We're getting there. I don't know why we're getting a slight bit of like light that shouldn't exist right here. The skylight's off. That's off. Wait, that's okay. What could be doing that? Because I don't have that on. Does that even do anything in this room right now? A little bit. Lightens up things a tiny little bit. Well, it's skylight if I turn that on. Yeah, that does that. Which I don't like. We do need a light in here, though, so that is a light. There's rect light. I can use spotlight. Let's just do a point light. Right there is the center of that thing. Right there. Okay. I might have made things too big. Can I bring an empty character? I might have made things too big. You know what that means? Let's take all these and let's try one. That seems to be about the right height. Okay, yeah. Sometimes I don't get scale right. That's fine. Let's do what I was doing before with that light. Yeah, now the light's the right scale. Things. That's fine. So if we put that into lighting, let's turn off world lights and let's light everything up. Okay. Those two. I think that's it. No, that isn't it. Where's the light? Back further. Is that it? That's it. That's the light. Okay. I'm right in the center. Cool. That one's lower. Oh, because that's a raised ceiling. Okay. Save all, just in case things crash. You never know. Okay, we got those lights. Let's get these other lights. It's just easier to do it like this because it's like a weird tilted map. Excuse me. Now you, what are you doing over here? You better be inside. You're going to be sleeping with the fishes. See, there's a light bulb for reference for me. That makes things easy. Okay, we got to do something though. Because that light bulb is solid. So we got bulb, home bulb. Well, since that's used everywhere, I can, let's see, I could do masked and just opacity mask parameter 0. Yeah, I could do that and just make it invisible. Then I don't have to do each light bulb individually. And there you go. You got a light. I'll adjust the intensity levels and everything of those later. That's fine. Okay. Let's get this one. Ooh, that one casts a really neat shadow there. Because what's that? Oh yeah, the coat rack. Coat. Okay. What am I supposed to do with a gun rack? I don't even own a gun, let alone many guns that would necessitate an entire rack. That would appear to be all of those. Okay, we're not fully lit. There are other lights over the bar, it looks like. Now, if those unlit, tell me about you. Master Paris Lantern. Here, your Paris Lantern. Does this have an alpha that I don't have here? Emissive. Spec. I mean, I'll take them. Oh, yeah. Gotta do that first. Did you import? What did you do? Doesn't have a normal map and everything else, so what was this? Thank you. Okay. There is metal on this one, and it didn't really detect what I want to call metal. So it's using hard light default. See if we could find one that just kind of gets what I want off of this. I like this one. Yeah, I think that's 75. I might just do my own. Okay. Because I know what parts are metal on this, so at least I think I could tell. So let's load this up. Okay, so that whole, this whole part right here, there's a smart way I could do this, let's see. Okay, that and invert and let's see, the whiter something is, the more metal it is. Let's just invert and this fill black. Let's just try that. Okay, I need to put a light over here. Get over here. You. Yeah, bub. Yeah, I need to make the chain alpha. That's fine. It's off the chain. Oh, I could do that up there a lot easier. Did that have no alpha in it? Okay. And specular does, which I don't understand. It's the fav at 90. Okay, I could figure this out. No, that will not do what I want. Yeah, it doesn't matter what it does to the colors. I just kind of need to bring everything up a little bit. And let's see if this does something cool. Okay, then I can basically do that. Now I'm having a brain fart. It's fine. Everything's broken now. Okay. Okay, and don't need any of that. Just up here. Like, I could probably do this a quicker way, but it's fine. I'm already doing it this way. That's such a small detail, but it was bothering me that it wasn't cut out. Doesn't have to be perfect, just quick enough so I get back to doing the fun stuff. This is a different kind of video for me. I've toyed around with the idea in my head for a while of it's like, Jack, you should record random crap you do during the day on your computer. And yeah, who knows if I'll upload this. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. Okay. That is off the chain. I want that to be white, and then select the inverse, and wait a minute, I can make this easier on myself, couldn't I? New layer. Let's just see how that is for now. Oh, that's not what I want. Deselect, deserono. Oh, it's in this. Okay. That's fine. Okay, let's just see what this does for now. We will save as, call it trans. And lantern. I change this to masked. Bring that over here. Oh, come on. Let me. Thank you. Oh, derp. I totally forgot it would do something like that, but watch what happens. Look, I got a nice chain now. Where did the lantern go? Oops. Okay, you have to make everything else that is solid, solid. That's fine. Okay, I could fix it. That's why I did layers. Okay. Just thinking for a second here. We're going to need another layer. And we're going to paint on some white. I think. Yeah. It's fine. Oh, no, it's not fine. I would rather me just do this. Okay. Yeah. I think that will be good. Then we're going to go over here and re-import. Yeah, that did what I wanted to do. Nice. And I get two-sided so you could get the interior. I might clean that up a little bit. Wait, what happened over here? Oh, because it's two-sided. Okay. Yeah. That's fine. It's still not fine. What's with this? Is there two here? What am I experiencing in my life right now? That's black, isn't it? That's definitely black. Call it masks and masks. Yeah, because it looks fine there. It's definitely see-through. But that definitely isn't. What do you think's doing that? Here, let's go into mesh editing, go into edit mode, and we will see that there is how many different planes here. Oh, I don't like what's happening with this. This is a simple plane, but it's just really dumb. I might have to edit this in something else. That's not working for me right now. Okay. Oops. Interior. Let's take a look at it. Oh, that is weird. Okay. Okay, what are you even doing? Why are you so many sheets? Look at this. I guess he tried to make it double-sided geometry without... It's dumb. I don't like any of this. get over here. Plane. Where the heck's my plane? This is so dumb that I have to do this. Okay. Okay, so we have this, and I have to texture that, which sucks. Really, all that needs is this top part. So, I think I selected it all. Yes, sir, I did. And we're gonna crop that. So we have this. Balls. So we got the chain. The chain goes on the plane. Cubic. Wait, yeah. What is that even doing? That's kind of not doing what I want. How do I rotate this? If it's cubic. Yep, 90. That doesn't look bad necessarily. Where is the original one? And this nowhere. Yeah. ND seems to work right there. Okay, we'll make that one. Think it's anchored on that side? Oh. So if I... No, it's not anchored on that side. Where is it anchored at? Ah, there we go. That works for me. Like right there. Let's call it 80 on that. Look, that'll do. That will do. Now, you just gotta copy it and say it's plus Z right now. How can I very easily can't because, you know, my life, it's good. It's good life. I forget which one's which direction. That should be about right. That looks better. Sorry I had to fix that, but, you know, that's just garbage. We go an extra step here. And let's take this. And crop and save as chain trans. Hey, let me pick you. Thank you. Aha. See? That's a chain now. That's a lot better. All of that for that. That's bullshit, but whatever. Because the way I have the materials set up in Unreal Engine is it'll already be two-sided, so you don't need two planes for two-sided. It's, you know. So I could connect the objects and annoyingly move them to the rest of the lights. Yeah, because look at that original. That original is a mess. Okay. Let's go over there. Let's hide that. Select that. Boom. And start deleting these. Pick this one. and this one. Oh, Cinema 4D is doing the weird camera thing where it just gets slow sometimes. I think it has to do with like moving too far away from the origin point or something. I don't know. It's always done this. I just deal with it. Just use Blender. Nah, look how quick I'm able to do all this. I'm never using Blender. Blender is garbage. Just my opinion, really. But it's a good opinion. Cinema 4D's UI is great. Where are you? No. I thought the plant was it. Okay, all those chains are set. Okay. If there's anything else that's weird, I will encounter it and it'll be fine. Let's save it as a C4D and export as that. Okay. Interior underscore fixed. Let that save. Free up some memory. Let's close that. Let's close this. Close that. Close that. Okay. Now, I don't have an elegant way to do this because the whole thing's a whole bunch of different things. I mean, yeah, I don't have a way to fix that. So let's just import it the old-fashioned way. I think there's a C4D importer that I enabled as a plugin, but I'm not going to use that right now. Yeah, it's fine. Whatever. Now, this is such a dumb way to do this, but whatever. Oh, it's annoying. I mean, I guess that's importing, whatever. Let's, I could do this, which I like this idea. Come on, computer, you can do it. I believe in you. I could do this. And export just the chains. Yeah, you're fine, whatever. Okay. I have just the chains. And if I bring that into here, put that at da. I think that might have worked. So let's take. Wait, where, what? Okay, yeah, that still is broken on these. So we're going to do mesh editing on all of these in Engine. And we're going to. Can't I just like freaking. Like that. Cool. Know where just the chains went to. Oh, that texture's fucked up. Whatevs. Whatevs, bro. They're over there. Oh, yeah, that's right. Plop them in the position. Okay. Well, I mean, at least if I overwrite that, I could fix that. That's fine. Cool. Okay, so let's edit this one. Those should all be like mesh instances, I guess, if I wanted to be technical and fancy. Instantiation. Okay, those are all done up. Okay, let's make that masked and bring that in, opacity mask, save. Okay, that's kind of what I thought would happen. It didn't look like it was the right direction. Okay. See, I don't know how to do UV shit. So how do I... How do I make sure that this saves the way I want it to with the texture doing what I want it to? So I make that UV mapping, and which one's that? This one, I think, because it's all fucked up looking. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing in the thing. Okay, and re-import. No, that's not what I want. I don't know where the chains are. Look, I don't even see the object, so there you go. There they are. Thank you. God, stop moving so fast, camera. No, that ain't gonna. Okay, so I'm not gonna do any of that shit in here. That's fine. And when I open this, what does Cinema 4D see? Yeah. Okay. So how can I copy these to this? Look, I'll figure this out. You like but it doesn't have the tile, it doesn't tile. Oh, yeah, maybe I'm going in the wrong direction. There's 0.1, 0.1. That's way too much, but let's see what it does on thing. I'm utterly confused. Hmm. Okay, we got copies here that I can mess with. Yeah, and that's kind of like what we're seeing right now. So, how I do thing help. Let's start with that. Remove that, please. Thank you. What did I break here? There we go. Okay. We're learning together here. Okay. I'm kind of understanding things. What if I don't want to do that, though? What lets me do that? Okay, that does it around center. Yeah, non-uniform is kind of what I want here. Okay, let's... Can I rotate you? Oh no. I can't tell if that's crooked. Oh boy, okay. Like... Okay, let's try that again. Rotate, got the rotate tool. Snapping. Yes. Yes. K. Move tool, snapping point and edge. So if I put it... This seems seems like, you know, like a usual thing that someone would know how to do. What I'm doing right now, you know, I don't know what I'm doing. It's painful. Honestly, that's all I needed, and that's fine. So if I could do that kind of UV to every single one of these, I'm good. Honestly, that's fine. I don't need to do any more than that. I don't care that the fucking UV is up where it is. It's fine. Jesus. Okay, let's go back to standard. I wonder. No, I can't. That's not a thing. Can it just be like replace object with? That would be great, please. No. Okay. I think there is actually maybe retarget. No. Okay, it's fine. We can do this. Go here. Go, just put them on top of one another. It'll work. Fully functional planes. This should work now, please. Just the chains, please. I'm switching between all of these different things. I keep forgetting like how things work in different programs. It's weird. Okay. Just the chains, please. Yep, that's fine. Look, listen to me here. This worked. Trust me. Just gotta trust me, okay? Two-sided, masked. That up there, so I could drag this over here. Hey, let me drag it, not behind it. That's so dumb, I hate that. Let me bring this, opacity mask. Apply. Aha! I figured it out, because I'm smart. Yeah. Okay. Now I could take this. No. Need to be closer because I can't see shit. Earth and View is great, by the way. Use it pretty much constantly. Oops. Just don't click on the selection box when you're using the selection box. Like I just did twice. Sorry, I'm trying to rush. I don't even know why I'm rushing at this point. Because I'm losing my mind, really. I'm working on chains for an hour. There you go. I can't break these cuffs. Save original folder. Let's get this. Well, it says it doesn't need specular, but but it does change materials because reasons. Because metallic materials aren't all 100% metallic all the time, so reasons and things, you know? Change that to masks and change that to masks. Your highest. No. Why is world no mipmaps? Nothing has mipmaps. What did I do? I don't know what I did. I broke it. I'm sorry. Thank you. Maybe it just doesn't need a MIP. Yeah, that's fine. That is acceptable, and I'm okay with that. Just don't have a normal map on these yet. We could get there. We were doing this guy. Fucking lantern. I'm sure that's fine. I shouldn't have deleted that light here. It doesn't look quite how I want it to. Let's change that metalness to my metalness. Okay, see, that's all the metal parts. That makes sense to me. Yes, correct. Normal map could use some work. Not quite what I want. Let's do that parallax trick again so I could see it. Can I mask this with... Where was... Yeah, Street Paris Lantern. Okay. Or should that be... Okay. Yeah. It's... Find whatever inverse and fill with white. That's fine. It's fine if that's like that right there. It's the mask. There you go. Is there another way to do displacement? Yeah, off of normal. Which I like that kind. I like doing it that way sometimes. It's kind of neat. How else can you do normals? Displace lines normal from a normal. Okay. Yeah, that's incorrect. Yeah, look at that shit. And that's all pillowed. Not changing anything to change the mask height. Why is that? This isn't changing. What the hell?
what the hell's going on?
Oh, because I loaded the mask in the normal, not in this. Herp-a-derp. Jesus. Yeah, 50 is good. Okay. I got lost somewhere in my head when I was doing this. I have spec. Where did it? Oh, yeah, because it was already made. Yeah. What can I do? Go back to PBR because I'm confused. I could. Oh, no. Do something like that. That looks really cool. Okay. I like that. I don't know if I change the metalness at all. What's the other way you could do a metalness? Just from diffuse. Okay. Yeah, I guess hard light's the only way to do it. Oh. Yeah, that's what I was trying to do. Wait, how did I do this metalness? That metalness is way better. Yeah, how did I get it looking like that? How did I do that? I don't know. I don't remember how I did that. Because that's a good metalness. Okay. Yeah, spec didn't change anything. What's the AO map look like? Use that. Okay, yeah, that sucks. I'm not using it. Yep, that's right. That roughness is right. I think I already saved it, but let's save it again. And oh, that's doormat. Where's roughness? Oh, it's not in here. There you go. Yeah, just for the hell of it. Might as well have the emissive in there. Oh, let's just see what that does. Okay, so we have base color. We have metallic. Specular. Roughness. Let's get rid of roughness for now. Got the opacity mask. We got the normal. Okay. Okay, you see that there's a little bit of an issue because it's doing that with this part I'm masking off. So I want to mix. Yeah. You see what it's doing there? Okay. So now if I take that as a roughness, ooh, I could deal with that. Oh, that is looking like a material now. Okay, holy moly. And this is roughness. Now we re-import. Didn't really change all that much. Maybe it's because I have the specular part on. I wonder if that screws with things. Oh, aha. That looks better. No, it doesn't actually. No. Okay. Okay, that's all fixed up now. Oy, you know, it's a lot of work. And there you go. Well, I walked through this much of this. I think I'm going to call it here. I'm going to do more of this, I think, definitely.